In this video, I painted a squad of Orc Storm Boys. This is a commission for Tyson. He's new to 40k and he would like to collect some orcs, so I'm helping him design the color scheme. We use an online painting tool to test out a few different options. I'll leave a link to the Reddit in the description so that you can test out your own color schemes. He came up with 5 options. Before I can paint, I need to build the orcs. Here's a little unboxing action for you. Cut out the parts and give them a clean. This is my first time building orcs, so I'm unfamiliar with how the parts come together. The rule of thumb is to dry fit before gluing. Always remember to apply even coats of glue and not to go overboard. Like the Fate Skimmer. To celebrate finally having a mini with a gun, I'll need to take an extra step and drill the barrel for a more realistic look. Always make a guard using a hobby knife, then followed by a pin vise, carefully drill out the barrel. Rinse and repeat until you have a complete mini like this. And same for the rest of the squad. I start by priming each mini with a pre-shade. Now, as I said, Tyson liked 5 different schemes and has even picked out shades, so I'll break each scheme down one by one. For the first scheme, a dark grey with purple armor plating. We start with a green airbrush over all the flesh. To make things easier down the road, I airbrush all the bone elements with an off-white to achieve a smooth finish. I start picking out the armor plates with a purple and a red for the collar and wrist wrap. I then paint the underclothes with a dark grey and the harness black. Then I add some chrome for the weapons to provide contrast against the dark clothing. Copper is used to provide definition between elements of the weapons, and I use some of the same red to paint the ammo belt and a black wash over everything. Time to dry brush the mini according to colour. A lighter purple on the purple areas, silver on the metals, and so on. I painted the eyes blue. The easiest way I find to paint eyes is to just dot it in. As for basing, I painted the skull a bone color followed by gray on the rubble. I used a concrete texture paint to tie the base together. I used a black wash over the concrete and brown wash over the skull, then give it a dry brush. Tyson was enthused by the idea of snow on the bases, so with a little snow texture, we break up the gray of the base and add a dynamic snowfall over the mini. To wrap up, as always, I paint the rim black. Now we move on to the second orc, which is gray and light blue. We start doing the green as we did earlier, focusing on the flesh and picking out the little bone details like the horns on the helmet. Blue comes next on the armor plating, jetpack, including the shoes, and a light gray for the pants and a dark gray for the top and wristbands to break up the colors on the torso. Time for the weapons. I start with the gunmetal for the axe and copper for the pistol, and use a chrome on the chest harness. I paint a dark gray for the lower legs and helmet to further break up the colors. The harness and cabling are painted black as requested in the color scheme. Since the jetpack's looking a little like a brick, I use a chrome to paint the turbines. And lastly, I paint his teeth purple. I then airbrush on the brown wash to see the different effect an airbrush can have on the wash procedure. Personally, I don't think airbrushing a wash gives the right effect. The finish is more of a stain instead of a shade. A dry brush for the mini according to the corresponding colors, and silver for the metal elements to add some chipping damage. A quick and easy base this time, brown on rocks, black on the tire, followed by mud texture, and brown wash over everything. A grey dry brush on the tire left it a little too light, so I used a second dry brush of black to bring the colour back. Then I add a brown dry brush over the mud, and some snow texture to break up the greys, to consolidate the orcs into a squad. client also wanted to try some blood effects, so I applied some over the Mini's right side and stained the snow beneath, and finished out with a black for the rim. Number 3 is very similar to the first orc, a light grey for the legs, light purple for the armor plates, and dark grey for the chest. And here we go. We start by doing the flesh, big surprise right, followed by the bone details around the jetpack. Time for the armor plates, a light purple over the jetpack, boots, and various armor plates around the Mini. I follow up with dark grey, being careful to avoid the armor plates. I also do the grey on certain wristbands, as others will be painted red later. Followed by a light grey for the pants, and now we put the red on the armbands. I paint the right hand blade gunmetal, and the left hand pistol in chrome, creating a dynamic shift across the Mini. I use the copper on the central harness and paint the teeth yellow. Meanwhile, the gloves, cabling, and harnesses are painted black. With the goggles, I thought I would try a new approach to its eyes and how to paint them. I started with blue on the lenses with a dot of light blue acting as a highlight. Finally, it is blended together with a blue glaze. This provides the lens some pop. And now is where the fun begins. I use a wash that matches the base color of each part of the Mini. Green on green, purple on purple, red on red, and black on the metallics. The end result is a lot crisper and defined compared to the first two Minis. I dry brush the Mini to give it a highlight. I also use a metallic dry brush over metal areas to simulate chips and battle damage. We have another concrete base, so we start by painting everything grey. However, this base has one small detail, an Ultra Smurf helmet. Working from the lens out, I paint it red and the rest of the helmet blue. To wrap up the base, I add a layer of concrete texture paint, followed by a black wash, a light grey dry brush over the concrete element, and a light blue dry brush over the Space Marine element. Then add some snow texture onto the base, and finish up by painting the rim black. Orc number 4 has a purple and blue color scheme. So this time, I'm using a different green as requested by Tyson. This green is lighter compared to the previous green I was using. This kinda reminds me of someone, I just can't put my finger on it.
Donkey.
Then I add an off-white for the bones. Blue for the armor plating, shoes and jetpack, a light grey for the bottom, purple for the cloth elements, and a lighter purple for the teeth. A grey for the goggles. Similar to the last orc, I painted the lens blue, and I add a dot of light blue and blend it together with a blue glaze. Copper for the bullets, chrome for the chopper, and gunmetal for the pistol. After painting most of the orc, I noticed the various straps on the jetpack, so I painted them the same purple as the other cloth elements to give the Mini more dimension. Similar to the previous orc, I use a wash that matches the base color of each part of the Mini so that I can get the clean result. A dry brush for the Mini according to the corresponding colors, and I only give a metallic dry brush to the chrome and gunmetal, because I want to have a new shiny look instead of it being battle worn. For the base, I paint the rocks brown, then I add the mud texture, followed by a brown wash and dry brush. I decided to go for a heavy snow look, so I covered most of the base and Mini with snow effects. And finally, black for the rim. For the fifth and last orc, this is the color scheme I'll be referencing. I airbrush the same Shrek green for the flesh tone. I pick up the jetpack armor plates with a light purple, then I paint the shoes a dark green. I give all the clothes element a blue base coat, a red for the mouth, and an off-white for the teeth and earring, chrome for the ornament on the helmet, eyepiece, and wristband. And I give the pistol and axe a copper base coat, a black for the harness, red for the eyes, and for the eyepiece, I start with a red followed by a dot of pink in the center, and I blend it together with an orange glaze. This time I'm going for a dirty look, so I added a brown wash to the entire Mini, a dry brush with the corresponding colors, and to change things up, I dry brush with an orange for the metallic elements to add a rust effect. I went with a lighter brown for the rocks on the base, and I added dirt texture paint to blend the rocks into the base. A brown wash is added to shade, followed by a light brown dry brush. Then I added snow effects. And for extra pop, I applied some blood effects over the model's left side and on the base. Finally, finish up with a black for the rim. Every orc here has a unique feel, showcasing different elements tied to light. And hopefully you can use these to determine what scheme he likes. While every orc is unique, hopefully this squad could be consolidated into a unified scheme over the grander army. Thank you for watching the video, and see you in the next one.